Whitehall is the only remaining home of Henry Flagler, who had three built. This one was completed in 1902 and took only 2 years to build, amazingly. Unlike most of the fine homes you see here in Florida, it's not made of wood and plaster. It's actually made of granite and marble. He gave the home to his new wife, Mary Lily Keenan, as a wedding present. It was intended only as a winter residence. The Flaglers travelled down every year in one of their own private rail cars, rail car number 91, now on display in the Flagler Keenan Museum, which was constructed to resemble a Gilded Age railway palace at the southern end of the grounds. Jean Flagler Matthews bought her grandfather's mansion in 1959 and, after costly restorations, turned it into the museum you see now. Here we see the drawing room. Silk wall coverings and draperies adorn this ornate Louis XVI style room. Here we have the formal dining room with its incredible ceiling, silk wall coverings, laid out as for breakfast. Boy, they must have had some breakfast. This area was once part of the exterior of Whitehall, but while it was at a short time for a hotel, it was converted into a dining area. This is the barreled ceiling for the hallway that leads to the grand ballroom. The most famous party that the Flaglers held here was to commemorate the American Revolution. All the ladies and gentlemen were dressed up in white powdered wigs. It must have been quite a scene. We now move on to the music room, which is just incredibly ornate and has its own 1000 pipe organ, which we were very fortunate to be able to listen to playing. The bedrooms were, of course, equally sumptuous, with the finest fittings, bathrooms, and furniture. 98% of the furniture in the whole house is original, and it's in incredible condition. The grand staircase is fitted with bronze railings of a very intricate design. And here's a bust and portrait of the great man himself. The portrait shows his piercing eyes and stare. Flagler really was responsible for the development of the whole of the east coast of Florida along the Atlantic sea line, with his railways and hotels and city building. He really put St. Augustine, Miami and Key West on the map. For a 50-roomed house, the garden with its fountain is remarkably small, but does provide a very shady, cool environment. Outside the main entrance are two magnificent planters, themselves absolutely huge in size. A magnificent exhibition hall has been built to house Henry Flagler's own railway carriage. Of course, being a railway baron, you have to have your own railway carriage, like many of the other rich Floridians and Americans. It of course came with all mod cons. And a bijou kitchen for those sumptuous little dining events. Henry Flagler died in 1913 following a fall while staying here at Whitehall. But one thing's certain, his life had a profound effect on everyone here in Florida and most of America as well.